会带走，会带去，会带来。嗯，就切得干净。
对，这个，主要是我也想让人看的，这个实际上呢，就像是在我自己那儿禅修嘛，这个也不是一个展览。
嗯。对，这个酿刚好，
可以哈。
嗯。
青蛙去，青蛙。
It's a little muffled on that speaker, but.
It's okay. It's okay.
No, it's very good. Look, the sunshine is calm.
It's good, right?
Yeah, and also the shadow from the tree.
But it's different, right? When you're looking at nature.
Yeah, different. And I like here. So it's like here's kind of the top of this area.
Hey, come on, come. Check it out.
Come on. 让你上那儿去。Oh, 他刚才在我手上。
往上。
So the idea is you just sit in the chair and listen to the music as you're looking out at the landscape. And the combination of the music makes you maybe see more things in nature and just sort of a moment of calm. The theme of the show is anesthesia. So to think about what can be an anesthesia for people. So I really like the combination of the music and the visuals to see if that creates sort of another space for people. Right, so it's more than just, if you listen to the music, it's one thing, and if you look at the landscape, it's another thing. But the two together sort of create a third space in your mind.
You want to fix the view and the sound mix in the,
yep.
in somebody's mind?
Right.
我们参加这个活动呢，我今天用了我的这个作品。这个作品我的原材料是使用这个，就是用过的这个鸡蛋盒，它是纸质的。然后呢，我在这个作品上头在创作，就点了这个红点，它实际上是这个象征啊，是一个母性，然后还有一个润玉，因为它是鸡蛋，它有生命的意义。然后呢，用这个包起来就是一种爱。我是刚才写的是 knife, love and mother, 就是生命，还有一个就是爱，还有一个 mother。母亲母爱，就是我的这个名字就叫润玉，刚才那个牌子在那儿，它是一个很广泛的一个含义，就是对生命一种热爱，就是给了它一种这个鸡蛋壳更深层的一个美学的一个含义。就是我们这个展览的这个团体啊非常棒，里头好多都是纽约州立大学的老师，还有一些很著名的一些策展人。我觉得在这个大自然的这个环境里头，它是一个叫这个户外试验展览，就是非常有意义，就是把我们的生命这个就是在这个大自然中间能更体现出来。就是你比如说我用了这个作品，然后它本身就是来源于生命，来源于自然。
现在这个状态是蛮好的。
你看他这个作品本身，它就有象征意义。就是说这个闪是本来是关照别人的，但是他自己现在已经受伤了，在暴风雨中受伤了，他需要关照。我们社会就是这样，你像医生，现在这个疫情来了，很多医生为了救别人，自己也中毒了，也感染了，对吧？也需要别人来救助他们。这个作品就是这个表达这个意识。哎，就主要是体现他这个坏掉，哎，这个瞬间，就是说他关照别人的同时，也需要别人来关照他。这个社会太需要关照。
是在哪里 ？POET，POET， 是。
身子好在身上。
对。是。我是个诗人，但是我是一个人，对，但是这个用134个国家的地区的语言都写的是同一个诗人的词，所以说我这个作品的名字叫134个诗人，或者更多，如果有来的参与的人，他用他的国家的文字来写诗人，那会更多，也就是我一个人可以代表很多。对，诗人就是一个人，是个个体还是个群体啊？就是这个兴奋，包括这个梵经，刚好我把它的边界，它这里本来不可以用的，这边是边界，我把这个它这个边界的这个石头把它拆开来，啊，做成一个踮脚石啊，就是作为一个台面，就是说诗人的兴奋由谁来决定啊？写诗的人就是诗人吗？啊，还是？大家都说你是个诗人，因为诗人他不是一个兴奋，对，他现在不是个职业，现在也不是一个兴奋，那么诗人是干嘛的呢？诗人的边界由谁来定义呢？啊，这就是我想说的这个，啊，诗人。
do I understand your shirt in all different languages?
他没有太多的主题，他就也是探索边界，探索一些模糊地带，我觉得这里面，也许对艺术品的什么叫艺术品，也可能也是艺术家思考的问题，很多都来自于居地取材，他们材质也不一样，比如说有生硬的、装置的，有用摄影工具做成这个造型的，通过先行品，来做一些想法，对。
So as a visual artist, I found myself a little stumped working with an area that pulls the light. And then the animation you'll see in the images here come from a conglomerate of root images. I've been working with roots now for a long time.The metaphor, the physicality of them, the uprootedness, the dislocation of so many people right now in this world, a similar dislocation as my own grandparents, as I'm sure many of us come from that. So roots, rootedness, uprooted, severed roots, all of that has been in a tangle in my creative process. So you will see images in here, but if it gets too dark, you will see them animated, and it's aconglomerate of roots that could never really exist. So it's as if you were under the tree looking up. And that template is part of the animation. The animation, as mentioned, is that template, and it's activated both by the sound, so it's the actual sound of the roots themselves, and by the poo. I think that's all I need to say, and a big thank you all for coming.And we wanted to start before it got pitch dark. So some people can go there and some here and know that it will darken and the image will get stronger. But then you won't be moving around in the dark yourselves. So thank you so much. And we're here to talk with you, Sophia you. And Jenna and myself.
Of grasping and release, of relief, of grief.